Good morning and welcome to Mission Control Houston. We're inside the International Space Station Flight Control Room for today's ISS update. It is Wednesday, January 18th. The team here in the Flight Control Room is watching over systems aboard the space station and following along with the activities of the Expedition 30 crew. The crew on board the space station is working through the mid-afternoon of its day, focusing on science experiments and maintenance and stowage on board the space station today. First up today, all of the crew members participated in a fire drill to go through the procedures if there were such an emergency on board. And then they separated off into various tasks around the space station. Space Station Commander Dan Burbank did some sampling of the surfaces inside the space station to return those samples for analysis on Earth. He's also doing some maintenance on the Advanced Resistive Exercise Device, which is an exercise machine on board the station that helps simulate weightlifting in a microgravity environment. NASA astronaut Don Pettit was working with a science experiment that is ongoing now as he is performing an ultrasound scan on himself with the assistance of European Space Agency astronaut Andre Kuipers. This is part of the integrated cardiovascular experiment. The crew performs a resting scan with remote guidance from the team on the ground to help with using the ultrasound equipment. The integrated cardiovascular experiment investigates the magnitude of the left and right ventricular atrophy, or decrease in the size of the heart muscle, that is associated with long-duration spaceflight. That measurement is done using MRI. And also the experiment relates this type of atrophy to measures of physical activity and cardiac work in flight. That is done by crew members wearing a monitor or a halter for several days at a time to monitor their activities. And then also, the ultrasound is used for this experiment to determine the time course and pattern of the progression of the cardiac atrophy in flight by using the ultrasound to do a scan of the chest. Pettit was the subject of the scan today with Kuipers' assistance, and actually Kuipers is involved in the experiment as well, as he's wearing the halter monitor as part of the experiment to study his activity for a few days. He has that to wear for another 24 hours. Kuipers also connected with students today. Earlier he conducted an amateur radio pass to speak with students at an industrial technical school in Belgium. And he's also helping with the sampling of the environment on board the station with analyzing some surface samples and water samples. Elsewhere on board the space station, the cosmonauts are working inside the Russian segment. Anton Shkaplerov is performing a periodic fitness evaluation today while exercising on a treadmill and working on some stowage audits inside the Russian segment. Anatoly Ivanishin and Oleg Kononenko are both working on different activities to help stow unneeded equipment inside the 45 Progress cargo vehicle, as that will be undocked and commanded to burn up in the Earth's atmosphere eventually. Its undocking is scheduled for Monday. And while the crew members are working on board the space station, there's some work being commanded from the ground here in Mission Control. The robotics flight controllers are operating the robotic systems on the outside of the space station, moving the mobile transporter, which is atop the railway of the truss structure, the backbone of the space station. That transporter is being moved about 100 feet down the truss towards the port side, getting closer to a location on the P3 or Port 3 truss where a platform is located, and a science experiment is on top of that platform. On Thursday, the mobile transporter will be in place with the space station's robotic arm and the Dexter, special purpose dexterous manipulator, on it to perform a survey of an experiment that's located on that platform. It's called the Space Test Program Houston 3 experiment, which is a complement of four individual experiments, actually, that are testing concepts aboard the space station for future long-duration missions. That experiment was installed during the STS-134 mission in cooperation with the DoD Space Test Program Houston office. The flight control team has completed the software transition, or the first phase of the software transition planned for this month aboard the station. That began on Sunday and lasted 3 days, upgrading the software on the major computers aboard the space station, the ones that perform the command and control of the complex, and some other computers, and the laptops inside the space station that the crew members use to interface with the station systems. There are other computers that will be upgraded as well in the second phase of that transition towards the end of the month.